When Foxborough Regional Charter School students began their Holocaust stamp collection in 2008, collecting 11 million stamps seemed unfathomable. Well, they finished the job in September and have been creating various works of art to display the collection. And last Sunday, the public finally had the opportunity to view the collection at an open house at the school. Charlotte Shear, a fifth grade teacher at the time, now retired, came up with the idea to help students grasp the enormity of the systematic killing of 11 million people. The 11 million postage stamps symbolize the 11 million lives lost during the Holocaust. The project was originally inspired by Lois Lowry's novel, The Number the Stars, which tells the story of a young girl whose family manages to smuggle more than 7,000 Jews across the Danish Straits to Sweden. The renowned author was the guest speaker at last week's event, and we are now joined by Charlotte Shear, the teacher who came up with the idea, and Foxborough Regional Charter School students, Sarah DeFonte and Tara Vallon. Welcome to Urban Update. Thanks for coming in. Great to have you here. Charlotte, let me start with you. Just talk to me about how you came up with the idea of collecting 11 million stamps. And also the figure using 11 million. I think most people are familiar with the 6 million figure of the 6 million Jews killed in the Holocaust. But you were using the 11 million figure, which includes a lot more people other than Jews.
Right. Well, the reason why there are 11 million stamps and not just six is because this is an educational initiative that took hold in a very, very diverse public school. The student population comes from many different backgrounds, and the children come in with many different levels of ability. And the discussion around Number the Stars was that at the root of what the Nazis did to the Jews was the fact that they were bullying them, persecuting, discriminating, and generally showing intolerance because Jewish people were different than what they saw in their ideal Aryan citizen. So we looked around the classroom and I identified different traits that would have been unacceptable to the Nazis, and determined that there wouldn't have been many, if any, left in our classroom had we been there at the time. And so when I told the children that there were 5 million people in this category, including people that simply stood up for others that were being persecuted, whose lives were taken, the children said, then we have to collect 11 million of something.
Slavs, Poles, Gypsies, and many others.
Exactly, exactly.
Okay. Now, did you ever actually think that you could accomplish collecting 11 million stamps? I mean, what does 11 million stamps look like? And where do you put them?
Well, first of all, we chose stamps because we thought that they would be easily accessible, that they were small, they wouldn't take up very much space, and how difficult would it be to collect these little pieces of paper? Well, at the end of the first collection year, we had amassed just under 25,000. And the children thought that, boy, we're getting close. Well, their math had a ways to go. I had hoped that we would get to 11 million, but I knew that it would depend on an awful lot of people jumping in and helping.
Okay. Now, girls, let me talk to you, Tara and Sarah. Talk to me about why you decided to get involved in the project. Tara, I'll start with you.
I decided to get involved with it because I thought it was really important for students like me and just other students of all grade levels to understand how terrible the Holocaust was, and stamps and collecting something hands-on that everyone could do sounded like a great idea to get everyone involved.
Sarah?
Yeah, I would agree with that. I thought for myself it was very important for me to better understand like what happened to those people. Because when I was in fifth grade. So when you're in fifth grade, you don't really know anything about what happened in the Holocaust. So it was really interesting for me to really fully understand what happened in the rest of the world and like just how cruel it can be.
Now, I want to hold up this little piece of artwork here. This is a project you make. You can just maybe explain what this is.
Yeah, so this is actually a portrait of two Holocaust survivors, Sam and his wife Goldie. And Sam actually was, he was at a bar mitzvah class and he came home to find his parents gone, taken away. So he ended up living on the streets for 2.5 years when he was just 13 years old. And after that, he himself was found and taken to a concentration camp where he was put on death row. And from there, he actually managed to escape. Mm-hmm. And he was taken to a refugee camp. Okay. And there he met up with Goldie again, okay. And they moved to America.
And they came to America. Mm-hmm. And my understanding is that they visited your school recently. They're still living.
Sam Weinreb was our guest speaker at the open house last year. We were very glad to have him. He told his story.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, you retired, but you started this in your teaching. Why did you want to stick with this project even into your retirement?
Well, it was very obvious that the project was bigger than any one person. And that it was going to take a very long time. And when I found a fellow staff member who really had the same kind of passion for continuing the work of teaching children that stamps that are thrown away when they have no more use, as if they're trash, could be a really good metaphor for what the Nazis did with human lives, I said, I'm passing the torch on to this person. And Mrs. Jamie Drosty has been a fabulous leader and supporter of the project and has kept it going and really rallied the troops.
Mm-hmm. Now, Tara and Sarah, I guess, tell me a little bit about, the artwork that, what did you, that you used to make the stamps, and did the individual pieces of art have any meaning to the Holocaust, do you think?
Yeah, each piece has, significant meaning to the Holocaust. This one is the story of two Holocaust survivors. We have others about the burning of the books and Kristallnacht, and each one utilizes stamps from different time periods and different significance.
Tara, can you talk about what you learned from this project?
I learned how important it is to keep history fresh in the minds of young people, because we're the future of the world, so it's important that we know all the things that happened before, and so that we don't repeat history, but also how terrible and toxic prejudice and racism and various other things that happened in the Holocaust can be.
Are there any lessons from the Holocaust that you think can relate to things that are going on today? That's a question for either one of you. Tara, what do you think? Sarah, you want to try that one?
Yeah, I would say for me, seeing other people kind of forget things like the Holocaust that have happened, it's really important for me and for us, I guess, to see that we're keeping it alive and we're keeping it fresh in the minds, like Tara said.
Anything that that stands out today, that lessons from the Holocaust?
Yeah, there are a lot of revisionist historians who are trying to disprove the Holocaust, so I think that it's very important that we keep the stories alive to prove that it did happen.
Now, Charlotte, last Sunday, you had an open house. Lois Lowry, who wrote the novel Number of the Stars, she was there. And what was the reaction to the event, to the exhibit, to the stamps? What kind of reaction have you gotten?
She was a phenomenal speaker to bring in to this at this particular time, with all of our stamps having been collected and the 18 pieces of artwork being done. And she really stressed the importance of the human connection as the way that we have brought in a vehicle for remembering what happened.
And what was your reaction from the people who came in and saw the exhibit?
There were people that had tears in their eyes. And people just could not believe that the events and the effects of the Holocaust could be represented so visually.
Okay, 11 million stamps. What an amazing project. Took a few years to do, but it sounds like the students and everyone who's seen the project has gotten a lot out of it. Charlotte Shearer, Sarah DeFonte, and Tara Vallon, thank you all for coming in. And congratulations on a monumental project. And something that I think is going to mean a lot to a lot of people. Okay. Well, in just a few moments, the longest-standing domestic violence agency on the North Shore hosts its annual Walk in Salem. We'll have more details right here on Urban Update.